Today's video about ruminants such as cows and humans actually are carnivores. And also I want to tell about some ideas how we can grow can feed the world growing population. As we know, life at this planet is supported by solar radiation. Plants convert carbon dioxide and water under solar radiation to glucose. There will be no carbon dioxide, there will be no life at this planet. Now the concentration of CO2 is 400 parts per million, while optimum concentration is above 1000 parts per million. So we actually should increase the amount of CO2 in air to get a more efficient conversion of sunlight to food, to glucose. But okay, this we'll make talk about in some other video. What else we are listening that vegetarians and vegans are telling us, oh, it is so much more efficient to eat vegetarian food because solar energy is converted to this vegetarian food, and we can eat it 100%. But only 10% of this solar energy from stored in plants gets converted to butter, milk, and meat by cows, and we eat with much less efficiency. It's of course absolutely not true, because cows do not eat grain. If you feed them with grain, they will be sick and die. Cows eat grass. They can eat straw. But we cannot eat straw. We eat, in the best, we eat bread, which is from grain. And we are getting sick of it. And we live short life. So, the plant cells are a part of this membrane, soft and elastic membrane, the same like in animal cells. They have solid cell wall, which is from cellulose. This gives some rigid frame to the plant cells. But also plants have fibers. And if we will look at the microscope, we will see that fibers actually go to microfibers, and then microfibers are made of glucose molecules. Here, glucose molecules in they can be in linear polymer or branched polymer, cellulose or hemicellulose. A part of cellulose, there is a quite considerable amount of lignin in the wood, and the lignin is such cross-linked phenolic polymers. They work as glue, but the most reason why the wood have lignin, it is to protect wood and the plants against bacteria and microorganisms. The more lignin have wood, the more stable it to bacteria and rotting. So these are phenolic polymers, which are in lignin, they are cross-linked, and they keep as glue and they protect wood from rotting. What happens when ruminants such as cows eat grass? They cannot digest cellulose because they don't have enzyme for this. But microorganism in the digestive tract of the cow can do it. The cow has a very large stomach, up to 300 liters. Yeah, this stomach is huge. And it consists of several departments. Grass that is slashed and chewed by cow gets abundantly moistened with saliva and enters the first section of the digestive tract, rumen. Rumen is a fermentation tank where microorganisms live and consume cellulose in grass. It takes up to 3 days to convert cellulose to glucose, and then this glucose is used by bacteria to grow. In these warm and moist conditions, the bacteria breed at high rate. In just 1 gram of the contents of the rumen, there are more than 10 billion bacteria and more than 1 million other microorganisms. Cellulose is food for bacteria, not for coal. Bacteria are the food for protozoa. But both bacteria and protozoa breed in this warm porridge at crazy rate. When the concentration of the microorganism in the rumen reaches a significant level, the coal sucks all the liquid together with microorganism in other sections of the stomach. They are first liquid saliva removed, and then it gets concentrated grass, squeezed grass burps and shoot again. What happens to microorganism? Microorganisms, they are going to stomach, to real stomach, here, this abomasum. In abomasum, a coal floods them with hydrochloric acid. Then cell membranes get destroyed, and the contents of the cells of this microorganism is absorbed into the coal bloodstream through the intestinal wall. Intestinal wall here in thin intestine here. This goes through the wall. That is, coal kills and eats living microorganisms, bacteria mostly. So we may consider the coal not as ruminant, it's actually really it is carnivorous. Carnivorous animals, that is predators. While grass is only used as food for microorganisms. Okay. When we look at apes, we will see that they have huge stomach, much larger than humans have. And the comparison gives us idea why. So we have a little bit longer thin intestine, and relatively small size, large intestine. Primates and apes have short, small intestine and large size, large intestine. Okay, here, what is happening in this? In the large intestine in colon occupies about 20% of the all human intestine's volume, while in primates and other apes, this is above 50%. At the same time, fermentation of fiber to short-chain fatty acids in the colon provides up to 10% of energy input for humans and up to 65% for apes. This is big difference between us and apes. We can get only 10% from this cellulose. Apes are getting 65. Well, in 60s, such a food pyramid was proposed that we can consume mostly grain and grain products such as bread and pasta and noodles, etc., and some amount of vegetables, fewer fruits, and even less milk, cheese, eggs, meat, and as little as possible sugar and salt and fat. Maybe in 60s it was not very bad idea, because I was a child already. I remember that bread was quite good, quite tasty, and all the vegetables also were good, and people didn't use chemicals to treat the vegetables and fruits, so it was safe and healthy to eat vegetables and fruits. Since then, situation is changed absolutely, and it is now from 60s, we see that in 60s, the amount of herbicides in US only increased 10-20 times. Amount of pesticides are increased also to large amounts. And if anybody think that this is good for your body to get these poisons for herbicides are poisons for plants, pesticides are poison for insects. And if you think it is good for you, it is not so. These chemicals may result in cancer, but also much more common it is, we discussed already, it is leaky guts. So as I live in Thailand, I such pictures that people spraying a lot of herbicides, a lot of pesticides to rice fields. It is absolutely common. And I am farmer myself. I tried to make organic farmer, but it is not profitable, so I gave up. I do farming the same as these local farmers. So, and then we put as much of chemicals as other people do. But for us, we grow healthy organic food. I do not consume these chemicals. I know this is a poison. And when I see how much chemicals are used to spray on fruits and vegetables, it makes me sick. Makes me sick to see it. And I got many problems with these fruits, poisoning by fruits and vegetables in this country. A part of these chemicals we are artificially adding to the fruits and vegetables and all vegetarian food. There are various types of molds which cause poisoning in people and animals. They produce mycotoxins. And this is a very serious poison, very serious and life-threatening toxins. And they cannot be cannot be broken down by heating or any mechanical treatment. So the accumulation of toxins are observed especially if weather is not stable. And this, as we have climate change, these conditions are very common. So the further and further, we have more and more toxins and poisons in vegetarian food. And then I seriously consider that to give up on consuming vegetables and fruits in this country at least, and or reduce it to some very necessary minimum. So when we get these fruits and vegetables soaked in poison, we consume them and they go to our intestine, and then what they produce so-called leaky guts. What are leaky guts? Normally these cells, they are in tight junction, and then the only small molecules can get through the cell membrane and then to food to the bloodstream. But under this poisoning and also under gluten, which is in grain, there can be inflammation and then gaps between the cells. And through these gaps, microorganisms, gluten and microorganisms and then toxins are getting directly to the bloodstream. Especially gluten with glucose attached to the protein gets to the bloodstream, can migrate any place to your body, and then produce inflammation. In inflammation, it is when our immune system attack the own cells and produce inflammation. I have myself this inflammation. It is psoriasis, and then you see this patch of pink colored skin, which is definitely not healthy, look not healthy, but it is now, it is even much better. I used to have huge problem because when I came to this country, they said, oh, I got to paradise with all fruits, cheap fruits and vegetables. I was eating so many fruits, so much vegetables that I got quite serious complications from this psoriasis. So, but much more serious problem in our joints, because when this gluten and migrates to our joints, then we will get osteoarthritis. And this is a real problem because it is pain in joints, it is a lot of inflammation, and that's it's a real problem. So they can kill you, this stuff. So is it worthwhile to consume all these vegetables and fruits soaked with poison and then to get this problem of leaky guts and to suffer? Is it worthwhile? Just I'm thinking, okay, I got to this suffer. And I have to find something more healthy because I care about my health. I do not want to suffer from this all this arthritis and osteoarthritis and all this psoriasis. I want to live a healthy life. And what to do? What can I do? So, okay, we will discuss it later. What I am doing? I think I have a solution. If we compare guts and intestines of rhino, which is and lion and human, we see that we are quite close to carnivores. We have longer, thin intestine, but and a little bit smaller, maybe the large intestine than a lion has. But in principle, certainly we are much different from rhino. Rhino gets most of energy from this bacteria, which lives in this large intestine. So, but yet we have to take care of all our body and make all our body healthy. So we have to take care and to provide healthy food with no toxins. How people who keep a carnivore diet use, and why we have this relatively large intestine, and then which is compatible with carnivores? Because normally carnivore animals, they consume a lot of collagen and cartilage and skin. And these are very stable molecules from amino acids, from three chains of amino acids, not easily. So they are not, they cannot be broken down by enzymes. And then only bacteria in large intestine can break it down. So I believe that if we eat ground meat and to in small pieces, it will help to our bacteria to consume it. But again, the people who stay on carnivore diet, they do not complain about any problems with digestive tract. In difference from them, I also keep a so-called rejuvenation program, and I consume metformin. Metformin is known that it produces a problem of loose stool. Loose stool, that it is not a diarrhea, but it's not nice. It is not nice to have it. I was looking for a solution on how to improve my health. And then I paid attention to starch. Starch is also comprised of glucose molecules, but bondage is between different. It is starch has alpha bondage, and here cellulose have beta bondage. Also, starch do not have lignin, so it is easily digested. But in plant cells, the starch is in small grains, which are quite compact. And then plants are using it as a source of energy. For example, at night, they store solar energy in starch, and then they can use this energy at night. But also in tubers, they store the energy to grow the new plants. There is so-called resistant starch. Resistant starch cannot be cracked, cannot be broken down to glucose by our enzymes. So it gets directly to the large intestine and consumed by bacteria in there. So it potato starch for me, and I mean potato starch has the highest amount or highest percentage of this resistant starch, and I use up to 30 gram of potato starch to keep my biome in large intestine healthy. It helps me very much. I don't have any problem anymore with loose stool. Everything worked perfect. Of course, green bananas and sweet potato and some varieties of rice can be used also. For example, as I reside in Thailand, in especially in northeast part of Thailand, people eat so-called sticky rice. They steam it and but eat later on cold. The sticky rice has up to 90%. They eat it with papaya salads. This papaya salad has no carbohydrates, no sugar, and a lot of fibers, and it's very spicy, so it is, I believe it is healthy food. So this sticky rice has almost 90% of starch, which is not easily digested, cannot be digested in our small intestine. So then I believe that it is healthy food because it goes to feed this bacteria, and bacteria convert it to fatty acids and to proteins, and then amino acids and fatty acids can go to our body. So it is, I believe this is quite healthy food, this sticky rice. But okay, and yet I'm quite happy with potato starch. It works the same. Sometimes I eat sticky rice. What else we can do with modern technologies to increase the amount of food produced at this planet, and this food not soaked in poison and the toxin, but healthy food? What can we do? So there is such technology which is like a steam explosion. What if we take wood pieces or pieces of straws and soak first them in diluted solution vinegar acid, and then heat above 100 degrees centigrade and at high pressure, so they will be saturated with this high pressure water and high temperature water, and then suddenly release pressure with the valve, then there will be a so-called steam explosion. And wood pieces or straw will be converted to these fine fibers of cellulose, and much of lignin will be removed with water. So this is how it works. So rice straw we soak to in vinegar acid, then we produce the steam explosion, and after the steam explosion, as it has a very low amount of lignin, it can be treated with artificial enzymes and converted to fermentable sugars. Fermentable sugars, okay, they can be used to produce alcohol for fuel, for example. And byproduct of this production is yeast. I eat two teaspoons of yeast every morning to get vitamin B1 and other vitamins, so I believe it is very healthy and easy to get. It is very cheap. It is $3 per, it is also $6 per kilo, so such prices. It's really helpful. I believe it's helpful. And also this cellulose, which is already with much removed, much lignin is removed, so it's easy for cows to digest, I mean for bacteria in cows to digest. It can be additionally supplied to cows which are fed by grass, which are on eat grass, and additional food they can get this from straw. And what about efficiency now? Then what is efficiency? We convert straw, which is more than 10 times by weight than grain. We convert it to food for cow. And coal converts to meat and butter and milk, and then we consume clean, healthy food, not this bread which is actually full of toxins and full of gluten, and gluten produce leaky guts, all these problems. If anybody want to get this problem, like psoriasis and and other stuff, it's okay, you are welcome. You decide what you eat. I would not eat bread. Actually, I was my problem with the psoriasis was when I got the bread making machine, and I was always like to make bread and fresh bread, and I was making bread myself, and I was eating a lot of bread and these fruits and vegetables, and I got this leaky gut problem. I got this psoriasis, very heavy conditions. Well, now it is much better because I already not making any bread. Okay, if somebody don't want to eat beef, okay, no problem. Dairy, what about dairy product? Cheese and milk. So with such automation, it would be very cheap, relatively cheap to produce milk. And so we can produce really with high efficiency, we can produce a very good food for humankind. Another opportunity. This cellulose, which is with a reduced amount of lignin, can be consumed by and to produce mushrooms. So mycelium is converting cellulose to protein and to fibers. And I was growing myself mushrooms in here. And it was really very healthy food, and I was feeling myself so much better when I was mostly on these mushrooms. Of course, the efficiency of conversion, like 1 kilo of dry straw can be converted to 1 kilo of mushrooms. As considering that 90% of mushrooms is water, okay, we have the same 10% of conversion of energy to food, but this mycelium and is the very good fertilizers. I used it myself as fertilizer. It is absolutely fantastic. It is the same as cow dung. It's very good fertilizer, so can use to improve fertility of the soil. So now I don't grow mushrooms, but prices for mushrooms are so low now that sometimes I can buy the skin oyster mushrooms only for one American dollar per kilo. And I buy, and then I use food processor to cut it to small pieces. Maybe we'll add some tin of fish, and then with coconut oil and garlic and bone broth, I make some bouillon or some quite delicious soup. Or like 2 days ago, I got this mushroom. 1 kilo is $2, $2 American per kilo. Little bit more expensive, but it's good quality. And together with garlic, in food processor, I ground it to such masa and boiled in with bone broth. Bone broth was used from, I eat mostly meat with bones, and bones I used to produce the bone broth, and then the meat I consume, and then I use this bone broth for this soup, mushroom soup, and it is delicious. I like it. So it's good food. Okay, so you see, this is my consideration that, okay, maybe the idea that we have to consume mostly vegetable and the grains, and this maybe was good idea in 60s, like 70 years ago and 50 years ago, maybe it was not bad idea. But nowadays, amount of toxins in vegetables, in fruits, in grain is so huge that it is killing us. So you just have to decide, will you pay money to kill yourself, to ruin your body, to get all these problems with leaky guts, or you will reconsider and maybe use as fibers to use potato starch, or maybe the sticky rice, because it's relatively healthy. And then you also consume protein from beef. Beef is the best source of protein. And then you see that we can go this way with modern technologies. We can convert wood and straw and other plants to high quality food for cow, for coals, and we can feed coals with this cellulose, and we can produce much more beef, much more meat, and we can eat this cheap, and not cheap, but okay, but it is really clean food, instead of killing ourselves with vegetables, fruits, and grains. So, vegetarians, please mind that there is no efficiency to consume fruits and vegetables, because if you will check out all the energy cost to produce the fruits or produce vegetables, and how to transport and how to make packaging and all this stuff, then it is much, much more than the relatively condensed food as meat and animal fat. Meat and animal fat, nowadays, the only way to keep healthy life, to eat healthy food, the only way, at least in this country, maybe somewhere. Again, if I stay at my farm and I grow organically, clean food, and then it is all, I eat berries, I eat fruits from my garden, from my orchards. But I never, if I buy at a supermarket, I am getting problems. And recently I got poisoned very much, and I don't want to have this problem anymore. I consider that I will cut vegetables and fruits to the very minimum, and instead will rely more on consuming animal meat. And coconut oil is okay, coconut oil, because it does not have much of chemicals yet. Coconut palms are grown with not much of fertilizers, not much of herbicides, and etc. Coconut oil is clean, good. What else? The sticky rice. Yeah, maybe it is okay, especially during some heavy exercises. It's good source of carbohydrates, and also it gives a very good food for our bacteria in our large intestine. Yeah, well, okay, so please consider to change your life, to keep healthy life, to eat healthy food, and comment, subscribe, like, ask questions, and share information with your friends and relatives, because our health in our hands. Nobody can help us. Now propaganda and advising is absolutely harmful to us. It's harmful. If we follow the propaganda, we will kill ourselves. We will really destroy our bodies. Okay, if I will try to answer to the questions in comments, and maybe produce some new videos. And take care, and have a beautiful, wonderful day. Thank you very much.